Hey health seekers, this is Kate Shimarani here, natural nurse in a toxic world. Many of you already know me and you're following my page, and I covered what I thought was happening with this whole V that's going around, and that video has done over a million hits worldwide. Now, we all know, everyone who's following me, that you can Google the effects of non-ionized radiation on the human body. There are military papers there. You can Google the effects of what aluminium does to the immunity. You can Google the effects of what any changes in the electromagnetic field of the earth does to immunity. You can also go on, look all on my page, and you'll see the new laws that were passed in Parliament at how you can be taken from your house if they suspect that you have this virus or you've been in contact with anyone. Now, today I was told by somebody who is working within the public sector, one of those public sector jobs where it's there to enforce laws, that they'd seen on the TV, it said that when you go into these hospitals, you don't come out. Now, we know there's football stadiums and lots of places that are being put together, and they're going to be makeshift hospitals. We're also told that the military is on standby. I've also had military personnel tell me they know something big's coming, and that their hangars are full of food, and that they're all on standby. Now, we also know that Trump mobilized another million reservist troops. He also did something that was unconstitutional, unless it's in wartime, where they can, there's something that's pulled open so that they can take private enterprises. I had a very high up member of government tell me today from Cambodia that they're now about to go on lockdown. So this is happening all over the world. Now we hear Tony Blair talking about we need a one world government to tackle this virus. I also know that there's lots of people that are experts in virus who've all spoken about this. Lots of doctors, lots of scientists. That's all on my page. I've also read studies where they couldn't confirm. It was the theory. Did this come from a bat or a lab? They could neither prove nor disprove that they believed it wasn't from a lab. That's not scientific evidence based. And yet the press took it up, circulated it out. It's from a bat. I know that you can't catch a virus from eating an animal. I also know that over 300,000 viruses live on the body that are activated when you become so toxic. That's how it happens. What I was told today, which is why I'm doing this video, has completely shaken me. I was told firsthand. Now, yesterday, first of all, I was told by a nurse that there were nobody in their hospital, nobody coming in the emergency room where she was a senior nurse in Dorset, and that she'd overheard another senior sister saying they were expecting a great big amount of people going into Salisbury. Now, 5G, the effects of radiation. Just Google that, non-ionized radiation, what it does. It's very similar to what they're telling you are the effects of this. So today I was told straight up by somebody about a doctor friend had told his sister, who's a doctor, that people that are in hospital, they are putting them into induced comas, old people, and from that they're dying. Then I was told, again, another piece of information, a 91-year-old woman. This was straight from the friend of the family. And I believe this. I have no reason to disbelieve this information. 91-year-old, hasn't been seen by a doctor in decades, starts to show symptoms of having what they're talking about with the... She's taken into hospital. She has an evening meal. Everything's okay. Then they get a phone call the next morning that she died in the night. So going on that... Somewhere in the press, if anyone else has seen that, tell me, when you go into these places, you don't come out. Now, we know that when you start saying there's a big pandemic and people are dying, if people are coming in with the symptoms, what are my medical colleagues going to do? This is against, it's against really what we're meant to do, preserve life. It's against medical ethics. It's against code of conduct. What is going on here, folks? Everywhere, people are sending me videos. They're sending everybody. People are putting it out there. 5G is going up everywhere. All around. I myself saw it all around the local school. Great big black LED lamppost with the antenna sticking out the side. This 5G is everywhere. I had some stupid man in a supermarket car park. We're observing the 6 foot rule. Oh, you'll be 6 foot under. It's funny that. I'm a Christian. How many sixes do you want to put in it? Just add another one. And he said, oh, what a load of rubbish, I'm an engineer. Non-ionized radiation is not dangerous. Well, he was clearly ignorant and I told him that, and he hasn't gone and read the papers. It is very dangerous. The only people who are telling you it's not dangerous are the people that are selling it. They're going to switch this on everywhere. That was switched on in Wuhan. It was switched on in Italy. I'm not saying that this isn't real. I'm just saying how you would catch one. They live on the body. What I'm talking about here is 5G. What is the bigger agenda here? When I see governments changing rules that people can come and take you out your house because you might have it, and then you might get sent to these centres, these football stadiums that have been taken over, military are all on standby. People, wake up. Wake up. Stop sitting on your piles of toilet roll. Stop sitting there watching your Netflix thinking, oh, this is going to be over and it's going to change. Things are never going to be what they were in January. That's all gone. It's all gone. Never has every government in the world come together and done this. Never, 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 never. Never. I'm a mum. I'm a nurse of 35 years. And for a friend to publicly say, oh, you don't work as a nurse anymore. What? Because I just don't work on that front line. I work in a different clinical area. I don't forget what I was taught. I don't forget how the human body works. Most of what I know now, I didn't learn in nursing school. I've learned an awful lot because remember, I was diagnosed with cancer and I turned my back on chemotherapy, radiotherapy, tamoxifen, Zoladex. My own brother-in-law said I'd die within 18 months. That was 8 years ago. I would rather die trying than on my knees to the corruption that is unfolding in front of you all while you sit there with your gobs open waiting for someone to come and rescue you. Go Google it while we've got the internet. Google non-ionized radiation. Google the effects of 5G, because when they switch it on, it's going to be exactly what you're told is the effects of this. And when you all rock up to the hospital and they don't have enough areas to treat you, then what's going to happen? Now in New York, they were already hollowing out all these Walmart, all these stores. They've got like towers on them like you would see in concentration camps. Now they've had 70 odd refrigerator trucks delivered, meat trucks. This is all there for all of you to see. Get off your Netflix and see it. This is just incredible. I'm a Christian. When Twin Towers went down, whatever your reasons that you believe it went down, I know how it went down and it wasn't what most people think. When that went down and people were so filled with fear, do you know it changed the energy of the earth? I read that somewhere in science. When you get loads of people praying together in a room, praying, which is what everybody should be doing, praying on your knees, that changes again. It changes the energy in the room. And it actually says that in the Bible. Pray. I'm going to do something later. Everybody should pray at the same time. 9 p.m. UK time, whatever that is, Pacific time, whatever that is, East Coast time, all over the world. We should all pray because we are being lied to and we are being deceived completely. None of this is right. None of it is right. People, while you have the internet, don't take my word for it. You go look, and we have a duty of care to protect our elderly, because that's where we want to be one day. We want to be old. We have a duty to protect our children so that they grow old. We have a duty to one another. Brothers and sisters, what can I say? I am totally disturbed. It's not often I get flustered, but look at the colour of my ears. Guys, this has really hit me when somebody tells me that and I can validate that information completely and they tell me because they're terrified of what they've seen going on. Anyway, Godspeed to everyone.
This is Dr. Cameron Kyle Seidel, ER and critical care doctor from New York City. 9 days ago, I opened an intensive care unit to care for the sickest COVID-positive patients in this city. In these 9 days, I have seen things I have never seen before. In treating these patients, I have witnessed medical phenomenon that just don't make sense in the context of treating a disease that is supposed to be a viral pneumonia. 9 days ago, I presumed I was opening an intensive care unit to treat patients with a virus causing a pneumonia that was ravaging lungs across the world, starting out as something mild, a cough, a sore throat, and progressively increasing in severity until ultimately ending in something called acute respiratory distress syndrome, or ARDS. This is the paradigm that every hospital in the country is working under. This is the disease, ARDS, that every hospital is preparing to treat. And this is the disease, ARDS, for which in the next 2 to 6 weeks, 100,000 Americans might be put on a ventilator. And yet, everything I have seen in the last 9 days, all the things that just don't make sense, the patients I'm seeing in front of me, the lungs I'm trying to improve, have led me to believe that COVID-19 is not this disease, and that we are operating under a medical paradigm that is untrue. In short, I believe we are treating the wrong disease, and I fear that this misguided treatment will lead to a tremendous amount of harm to a great number of people in a very short time. As New York City appears to be about 10 days ahead of the country, I feel compelled to get this information out. COVID-19 lung disease, as far as I can see, is not a pneumonia and should not be treated as one. Rather, it appears as some kind of viral induced disease, most resembling high altitude sickness. It is as if tens of thousands of my fellow New Yorkers are on a plane at 30,000 feet and the cabin pressure is slowly being let out. These patients are slowly being starved of oxygen. I have seen patients dependent on oxygen take off their oxygen and quickly progress through a state of anxiety and emotional distress and eventually get blue in the face. And while they look like patients absolutely on the brink of death, they do not look like patients dying of pneumonia. I have never been a mountain climber, and I do not know the conditions at base camp below the highest peaks in the world, but I suspect that the patients I'm seeing in front of me look most like as if a person was dropped off on the top of Mount Everest without time to acclimate. I don't know the final answer of this disease, but I'm quite sure that a ventilator is not it. That is not to say that we don't need ventilators. We absolutely need them. They are the only way at this time that we are able to give a little more oxygen to patients who need it. But when we treat people with ARDS, we typically use ventilators to treat what's called respiratory failure. We use the ventilator to do the work that the patient's muscles can no longer do because they're too tired to do it. These patients' muscles work fine. I fear that if we're using a false paradigm to treat a new disease, that the method that we program the ventilator, one based on a notion of respiratory failure as opposed to oxygen failure, that this method, and there are a great many number of methods we can use with the ventilator, but this method being widely adopted at this very moment in every hospital in the country, which aims to increase pressure on the lungs in order to open them up, is actually doing more harm than good, and that the pressure we are providing we may be providing to lungs that cannot stand it, that cannot take it, and that the ARDS that we are seeing, that the whole world is seeing, may be nothing more than lung injury caused by the ventilator. Now, I don't know the final answer to this disease. I do sense that we will have to use ventilators. We will have to use a great many number of ventilators, and we need a great many number of ventilators, but I sense that we can use them in a much safer way. In a much safer method. That safer method challenges long-held dogmatic beliefs within the medical community and among lung specialists, which will not be easy to overcome. But I really believe that they must be overcome. There are hundreds of thousands of lungs in this country at risk, and the time to overcome them is now. I'm confident that if those of us that work bedside with these patients, those of us who are witnessing the things that we have never seen before, despite the many years we have worked and the thousands of patients and diseases we have seen, if we can effectively communicate this to all those that are so important but who are not bedside, the researchers, the administrators, those who procure our resources and make our protocols, the politicians, our own government, if we are able to convince them that this is a disease that is different than anything we have ever seen, I am confident that an answer can be found, that effective treatment can be discovered, and that a plan to disseminate that treatment can be rapidly deployed, and that tens of thousands and probably hundreds of thousands of lives and lungs will be protected. The time for this is now. We are staring into a future in which a great many of our fellow Americans are going to suffer. We are all involved in this future. So I urge you, for those of us, if you are out there, for those who work bedside, I urge you to speak up. We can change this. I thank you all for listening. Please spread the message and stay safe.
In light of this important message of this doctor, who I want to add has nothing to gain at all by giving you this, unlike the plethora of people on the news like Bill Gates who have a lot to gain by you taking his advice. This man has nothing to gain and everything to lose. But I'd like to make a few comments, and please take my comments with a grain of salt. Don't believe anything I say. Do your own research. But I'd like to point out here that in my video on 60 gigahertz FIVEG, I roughly explained how the uptake of oxygen to hemoglobin can be potentially interfered with electromagnetically. Since releasing that video, I have had further confirmation by a molecular scientist specializing in oxygen. I'll show that later. But I showed how it's well known that 60 gigahertz FIVEG is absorbed by oxygen. I showed you footage of how the heads of telecom admit under oath there have been no industry-sponsored safety testing of these frequencies that they are saying they will release in an expedited manner. No safety testing on humans, no safety testing on the environment. In the video, I also begged that we need further testing to be done before we continue to unleash these frequencies on the world. That video was subsequently removed by YouTube. Now this doctor admits this, whatever this is that he's seeing coming into his ICU is unlike anything he has ever seen before. He says he's witnessed medical phenomena that don't make sense in the context of treating a disease that's supposed to be a viral pneumonia. The thing that they're telling you all over the media that this is without a doubt. He describes that the paradigm that they are told that they would be treating is ARDS, acute respiratory distress syndrome. End quote, yet everything I've seen in the last 9 days, all of the things that just don't make sense, the patients I'm seeing in front of me, the lungs I'm trying to improve have led me to believe that this COV19 is not this disease. He's saying it's not behaving as a viral pneumonia. He says, and that we are operating under a medical paradigm that is untrue. And he adds that he fears that this misguided treatment will lead to a tremendous amount of harm to a great number of people in a very short period of time. Are you listening? He's calling this oxygen failure. And he's admitting that whatever this is can be exacerbated by the use of ventilators itself. You heard him say it, not me, that as far as he can see it, it is not acting as a pneumonia and it should not be treated as one. Again, a head doctor in ICU in New York City is saying this, not me. I have no medical advice on this topic. I'm simply asking, can we confirm if 60 gigahertz frequency has actually been unleashed in New York City? Are there any whistleblowers out there who install small cell towers who have seen the frequencies listed on the side? Come to me and let me know where they've installed this stuff so we can start to gather this kind of information. Can we start to consider that just perhaps, just maybe, this thing is not what we are being told? Thanks for listening. God bless you. I love you. And I hope to talk to you again very soon.